ago when he was like going through his Marth phase. And I realized that if Marth. That's who you are. You want to get on? Yeah, you want to hop on her? Alright. I'll finish that thought later.
No, you're good. You're good. What's up, man?
What's up, Ben? How are you, man?
I'm doing all right. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm well, bro.
How's your weekend?
Chilling. Chilling, bro. I was in Vegas for the weekend.
Oh shit.
Went to a tournament, and I was watching DreamHack too. How's your DreamHack experience, bro?
We had this conversation before.
Yeah,
it was great.
But we weren't live in front of hundreds of people.
It's great until Game 5 Grand Finals. It was an amazing experience. It was a lot better when Manga was still in the tournament. The moment he lost, got a lot worse. But I stuck through it, and then I sat through Game 5.
Yeah, we can hear you in the commentary. Shout out to everybody in the chat, by the way. So what's that, Reggie looks like Freddie Gibbs. I can see that. Yeah, man. Oh, are we loud? Is it too loud? Oh. Sorry. Yeah, man, but what time did you get back today, man?
I got back yesterday at like 5 o'clock.
Oh, okay.
I went to the Twitch party on Sunday night, so I like...
Oh, yeah, so you were big chilling, bro. You're out here balling, bro.
That's one way of looking at it.
Yeah, man. I consider that balling, you know? Come to the Foundry right after just like living it up.
Yeah.
In Austin. And Austin's lit, too.
Austin is lit.
They got 6th Street and all that
6th
stuff.
6th Street is...
I know.
It's something else, man. I don't know how to describe it. It's like another world, another dimension.
Yeah. It's pretty crazy.
You were there for Battle of Five Gods?
Nah, Forte.
Ooh. Okay.
One tournament at a time. I'm not that popping yet, man. You know, we get the grassroots. You know what I mean? Your boys just started to get in the...
I was just trying to remember what other events were
in the invite lane, you know? Nah. Nah, it was for Forte. It was hella long ago. But I went to Texas again, but ooh.
Whoa.
I went to Houston, though, the second time. Clutch
never
City?
Been to Houston.
Yeah, Houston was cool. Houston gave me more like a Texas feel for sure. Like, Austin's like if San Francisco wasn't Texas, but like Houston's like Texas. Like, I'm like, oh, okay, for sure. This is like. Where
so
they get it in yet?
Dallas Fort Worth area. I've been there a couple times.
Yeah,
that's Texas.
Yeah. That's Texas as fuck. It's like, all right, it was hot as shit. Oh my god, it's like one of the most hottest tournaments I've ever been to. But it was in a basketball court or gymnasium, so that was fire. So your boy definitely pulled up from 30. You know, tried to get my Steph Curry on. My team lost though. We weren't that good yet. So hopefully next time, if there's a Clutch City and I go.
Yeah.
You know. Am I hurting your ear? Maybe it'd be louder. I should yell in your ear, Eero, just to be a dick. Just to piss you off. Hopefully that makes you feel better. Is it really that loud? Or I got to turn the volume down.
No, I think that's just for our headphones. Because Spencer uses that same device.
Yeah, but it doesn't feel... It doesn't feel like loud to us, but apparently, I'm not even talking loud. That's the best part. The mics are just up hella high.
So, what do you think about this matchup, man?
Doing no balls. Nah, I got balls still. Who do I think what?
What do you think about this matchup?
I think Sheik wins, but I also don't play this matchup at high level, so I actually don't know. I put the mic like super far away. Hopefully you guys like aren't super pissed.
I think they turned it down and we pushed the mic further away from her.
Yeah.
So now it's super like, quiet. We just hit the other end of the spectrum.
Now we're too quiet. Fuck. God damn it. Can't win, dude. Damned if you do, damned if you don't. What do you think about this matchup?
I don't know. I played a little bit of it. I think Marth has a little bit of advantage to the sword out ranges, all of Sheik's tilts.
Yeah.
But both of them, you know, if you're above one another in real bad territory.
Right.
So
see I like the difference of opinions here. I just feel like neutral is hella easy for Sheik, but
what is hella easy?
Neutral.
Oh, neutral, yeah.
I just feel like, but like I said, like I don't know. I play a Marth with Sheik and I probably would get destroyed. So. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. With the god, Ben SW.
You're the real god, dude.
Nah, I'm not the god, dude. I'm just Brandon, you know. You're the god. I don't work at Twitch, man. Homie.
I don't know what to say. Yeah. To you're right. I do work at Twitch.
You work at Twitch, bro.
Ooh.
Big Ben. Big Ben over here, dude.
Why didn't Phil come out?
The Falco Bowser guy. Yeah, Phil's just been doing his thing, man. League is on break.
Okay.
Until Royal Flush.
You going to that?
I am. Dude, I got to fly out. So my birthday's next week. I was thinking about coming here. But, like, I really want to go to an A's game, and it's a night game. So I think I'm going to do that. And then, my flight for Royal Flush is the day after.
Okay.
So it's like, kind of sucks, but it's all right.
Wait, you're flying out on a Wednesday?
Yeah.
That's wild.
Yeah. Well, we'll get there Wednesday night. And then Thursday, drive to fucking Atlantic City. So.
It sounds like it'll be a fun event. I mean, every event I've been to that's been in casino, mainly Evo. Smashers love casinos, is what I've learned.
Yeah, Smashers like to gamble, dude. Yep. Of course, it's going to be an A's game. I went to a Giants game for my birthday 2 years ago and fucking hated that shit. And they lost. So I'm like, yo, never again, dude. Shout out to the Giants, though. But fuck that. It like, made me mad, dude. One, it was super cold. Like, okay, you guys just hear me bitch about Giants game. One, it was super cold. Two, like, everybody there looked like they didn't give a fuck about what was going on. I mean, usually that is the case in baseball games, but at least, like, when shit happens, you, like, react. Like, everyone looked like they're doing business deals at the game.
So that's one of the things I realized after coming out here.
Yeah.
At Cubs games, everybody's into the game.
Live in Chicago. That's why.
This is, like, you know, 4 years ago, whatever, 5 years ago, when the Cubs are garbage.
Yeah.
Then you come here and you go to a baseball game, people are like, I don't give a shit.
No, you go to Giants games.
Yeah, Giants games.
Specifically Giants. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's not like that with A's games. Because the A's, they fucking play in East Oakland. They suck dick. So everyone that's there is just a genuine, they actually care about the team. They want to see the team prosper. And then there's like that third, no, not the third. That's too much. Like a fifth of people who are Giants fans but just couldn't get like a Giants ticket. So they went to the A's games.
The A's doing well this season?
Probably not. But, you know, I hope so. Dude, I straight up will cry if they win the World Series. That's bigger than them. That's bigger than the Warriors winning, dude.
Yeah.
The A's, like, oh, no, they've been, for the last couple years, it's been bad.
They've been real bad.
Yeah, like, really bad. It's like how the Cubs used to be.
Dude, I had to live for
that. I couldn't imagine being a Cubs fan now. So, like, if like, the A's won, and it wasn't even 100 years. So I can only imagine.
That's what I tell my friends. They ask me, am I happy about the Cubs winning the World Series? I feel bad because I kind of gave up. When I moved out to NorCal, I stopped watching baseball because I used to live like 2 blocks away from Wrigley Field. So I used to go to Cubs game all the time.
Yeah.
And I don't even feel like that. Like I should take that W, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like I gave up on them as a fan. I don't deserve, you know, feeling good about them winning the World Series. If I were a true diehard fan, I would have kept through them like I did for the other, you know, 18 years of my life or whatever.
That's thorough as fuck. At least you recognize that. You don't know how many people have been on the bandwagon train since.
Yeah.
You know how many Giants fans aren't actually Giants fans?
Same with Warriors fans.
Oh, Warriors, yeah. Warriors are, man. They don't remember the days when we go 20 and fucking like 40 something, you know, or 20 and 65, you know. That shit don't exist no more. When we had Thunder, when Baron Davis was on the squad, see, people don't even go far that far back. But you know, that's just what happens when you're popping, bro.
Yeah. The new stadium, the new Warriors stadium, is gonna be pretty close to where I live right now. So I'm not looking forward to when that.
Dude, I'm so hurt about the new stadium. Because you have that and the Raiders leaving. And now all we have is the A's. And they're probably going to leave.
Once like, they start doing well, they'll leave.
East Bay can't win, dude. Fuck, dude. Struggle's real, bro. East Bay's just a spot where you go to when it's too cheap to live in San Francisco. Sad. You know?
Yeah, I feel it.
There's no demand. One day, dude. One day the A's will win, then everybody will be all on their dick, and then they'll move to San Francisco or San Jose. Because that's what they'll want. You know?
That's where the money is.
Yeah. Not when you're good, though. Or not when you suck. I mean, yeah. When you suck, you stay in Oakland. And then you prosper. That one, you know, the Raiders got good. Now they're moving to Vegas. A's are next, bro. They're going to move to San Jose or, like, some weird-ass city that, like, you know, you just think about. It's like your layover, and then they're there now. You know?
Back to play.
Oh, let's go, Ben.